Fernando, it began with the Dodgers in 1980.
But there's more to Fernando's game that meets the eye, especially when you consider that he swung a mean bat all year and won a Gold Glove Award in his sixth major league season. Buoyed by the sparkling play of his elders behind him, Fernando becomes the first ever to win Rookie of the Year and Cy Young Awards in the same season. It's Fernando with 14 strikeouts so far. Make it 15. What a show he's putting on at the vet. Fernando ready in the strike two pitch. Is hit back to the box, dribbling to second. Samwell on the bag, throws to first, double play. Fernando Valenzuela. A no-hitter at 10-17 in the evening of June the 29th, 1990. If you have a sombrero, throw it to the sky.
You notice I have notes, like I need them for this gentleman. Ladies and gentlemen, here to say a few words about the great Fernando Valenzuela is a man that is synonymous with Dodger baseball. He's a two-time World Series champion. He's a gold medalist at the U.S. Olympic Games. He is one of the most popular sports figures ever in California and around the world. And I am thrilled to be able to say to all of you, he is my friend, and he's available in the Sports Lodge with Roger Lodge, the show I host weekday afternoons on AM 830 here in town, anytime we call him. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Tommy Lasorda.
Thank you very much, Roger, for that wonderful introduction. After I heard that, I thought I had died. But it's good to be here, especially for someone very close, someone who did so much for me as a manager. And I can remember the first word he learned in English was million. When I came here, my wife said, "Where are you going now?" And I said, "Well, I have to go to this dinner." She said, "You want to know something? I thought she said, after being married to you for 67 years, she said, you love the Dodgers and baseball more than you love me. I said, yeah, but I love you more than I do football and basketball. I remember one night I had to make a speech in Los Angeles, speaking to the FBI agents. And on the way home, I looked at the clock on the dash, and it was 3 a.m. I said, oh, my God, 3 o'clock in the morning. So I turned the lights off on the car when I pulled into the driveway. I didn't want to wake her up. I closed the car door very softly. That didn't wake her. And I opened the front door, and I took my shoes off. I'm sure you guys have done this before. And I started in, and all of a sudden, the lights go on. Where you been? It's 3 o'clock in the morning. You're out speaking every night, having a good time. I said, wait a minute, hold it, 1 minute. Took in the liquor cabinet, and I drew down a bottle of vodka, which I had sampled in those days. And I poured some in a glass. I said, taste that. She said, get that stuff away from me. I said, John, all I'm asking you is to take a sip. John, I want to take a sip. I said, come on, a sip's not going to hurt you. Take it. She took a sip. She said, oh, this stuff is terrible. And I said, see, you think I'm out enjoying myself every night. Well, speaking of our honoree tonight, this young man came from Mexico to the Dodgers, and it was a blessing. One of the finest competitors that I've ever managed. He wanted the ball anytime and every time. He did not ever know there was a bullpen because after the game was over, he went 9 innings. He never looked for anybody to help him. So tonight he's being inducted into the California Sports Hall of Fame. And Christian, I want to say this to you. Without you, this would not have been possible. You've done a tremendous job in putting this program together. I can remember when I was speaking with somebody and he said, how's the California Hall of Fame? I said, we don't have any Hall of Fame in California. He said, you don't have a Hall of Fame in California? I said, no. But Christian must have heard that and decided that we would have a Hall of Fame here in California. And Christian, from all of us, you're a tremendous man. And we thank you very much. For Fernando, he wanted the baseball all the time. He never was hurt, never missed a turn at pitching. He had the heart of a lion. He wanted to beat you real bad. He was a great pitcher. And I think he belongs in the baseball's Hall of Fame for what he has done for the Dodgers. He's been a great pitcher and a great person. He's come a long way. I used to have to interpret for him what little Spanish I knew. And one time the guy asked me to ask these questions and Fernando had an answer. He said, what'd you ask him? I said, I asked him how he enjoys playing for Tom Lasorda. And he said, great. He said, I really appreciate what Tom Lasorda has done for me. And it's Fernando looked up and said, I never said that. So he was a funny guy at times. And I'll tell you one thing. He could do it with that baseball. Courage, attitude, and ability made him one of the greatest pitchers that ever pitched in the game of baseball. And of course, we were fortunate for the Dodgers to have Fernando pitch and accomplish what he did. So tonight, Fernando's being inducted into the California Sports Hall of Fame. I'm proud of him, and I know all the Dodger fans are very, very proud of Fernando for what he has accomplished for the Dodgers. So tonight, Fernando, you get inducted into the Hall of Fame. And may God bless you, and may he keep you in a happy mood. Thank you very much.